Hello, good morning viewers. Welcome to my channel, Mwafala TV. In this tutorial, I want to show you how you can trace your pictures, how you can trace any picture using Adobe Photoshop. Some people may call it, I might call it Adobe Photoshop. So, let's get started. Go to Start menu. Before you this it, Adobe Photoshop CS6 64-bit. That's what I'm using. Click on it. Takes longer time to open. Yeah, it's opening. Adobe Photoshop CS6. It's opening now. That is the. This is. Here is Adobe Photoshop environment. Where you can trace your picture. Here you can trace picture that you use in any place. If you want to design. Want to design poster, handbill, thumbnail, anything. You must trace this picture to remove the environment, to remove the backgrounds. This is where you can trace the picture. So let's start. You go to file, open. Look for the picture you want to trace. For me, I would like to trace my picture. Because I will use my pictures, my jobs. I use it in my jobs. This is it. See the picture I want to trace here. I click on it. I say open. Yes, opened. Yeah. Do you see these tools? We have this one. Crop. 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 We have this one. Rectangle macro. So you use it to capture the area you want to trace. This is it. Capture the area you want to trace. This is it. I want to see my waist. I just want to try this. Then you right click on it, you say layer via cut, but I always use Ctrl X, so you block it, you say Ctrl X, it will cut. That is what I always use. If you block it, you say Ctrl X. Ctrl X in computer means cut. While Ctrl C is copy. I still teach about that thing in my Windows for beginners. So let's go. You go to file, say new. Okay. You go to file new. This place, look very careful. This thing, your new environment, the measurement and everything, What you do is this background content, you have to check it, change it to transparent background. Don't leave it at white, because if you leave it at white, after tracing you still have white background. Just leave it at the transparent background and click OK. You see it? Then you click Ctrl V to paste your picture. Ctrl V in computer means paste. You learn all those things, shortcuts, on my tutorial on Windows. So let's continue. You go to this place, you pick polygonal lasso tool, that is the tool that you use to trace. You click on it, then you start. You'll be clicking on the edges. If you want to increase it, press plus on your laptop or on your PC keyboard to increase, to see what you are tracing. You'll be tracing it one after the other. You'll be tracing it. You'll be tracing it. Let me be a very bit fast. Hold your, if you don't want to wait for it to go up, just hold your space bar. You see hand, then use your mouse to bring it up and down, depending on where you want to. Once you leave your space bar and mouse and continue. Yeah. Once you place your space bar, you see something like hand, then click and drag down to see the area you are working, then leave your space bar and continue. Let's join this one first. This is it. You have joined it. Give it further, you right click on it, you give it further. Further is always 2. Say okay. Then you delete. This is it. Click on minus to see the environment you are working. You see it? Then we start from here again. Let's do it a little bit fast. Go to further. Okay. Remember that a feather is supposed to be 2 layers. Okay, then you delete. This is it, you have designed it. Let's save it. Save it on desktop as one feather piece. Say okay. You're saving it on desktop. Find a map for the piece. Save. Okay. You are finished. You are finished. Unless you want to give it, make it more brighter. You click Ctrl M. You see it. Make it more brighter or more dim. You see it. Click OK. That is all about it. You have saved it, so we close. Yes, save. We close. This is where we cut it from. No, don't want to save this one. This is see map for the pics. It is here on our desktop. If you want to import it in any environment that you're working with, let's say CorelDRAW. Let's say CorelDRAW. Want to import it? Desktop. See it, one for the pics. Import. This is it. One for the pics. This is it. One for the pics. You've imported it. But let me show you the original one before we trust it. See the original one. This is it. So this is the one that we trust. So you can use Photoshop to trace your pictures and import it in the environment you want to work, especially CorelDRAW. Thank you for watching. I want you to subscribe to this channel for you to learn more about how to use all these programs, computer programs. Also, share to your friends to benefit from it. I'm still my father, TV. If you have any questions, type it on the comment section and send to me. Thank you for watching.